Hey, this video is part of our lab test series. Today, Pratyusha Aluri will run some tests on a very large setup. She's a software engineer in Cisco and she did set up two NCS5508 routers, each fully loaded with 36 ports, 100GB LAN cards, for a total of twice 288 ports. And she will run two big tests. First, loading the chassis with 28.8 terabits per second in both directions, with small packet size, IMIX, IPv4, IPv6, then with and without configuration on the ports. The second test will use this very large test bed to demonstrate ECMP load balancing between multiple link aggregation bundles of 64 members each. Now, I'll let Pratyusha running the test.
So this is the physical view. So these are two fully loaded 5508s, as you see, which are connected back to back with 100G AOC cables. Here I've just put two blocks. First block is to represent first router 5508-1, and the second one is the second router 5508-2. So the topmost, the port 0000, which is highlighted in black, connects to the traffic generator, and the remaining ports are wired back to back. That is, port 1 of line card 0 is physically cabled to port 1 of line card 0 on router 2. They're just mirror images. So this way, all the remaining 287 ports are wired back to back. This depicts how the VRF snake is set up on this testbed. So the numbering has been done in this slide. So number 1 represents the traffic that flows into the first router from the traffic generator to the physical link. And from port 0 of line card 0, the traffic gets switched through the fabric to port 0 of line card 1. And because it flows through two different line cards, the traffic flows through the fabric. This is to avoid local switching. From 2, the third part represented here is again the traffic that flows through the wire, that is port 0 on line card 1 of router 1 to port 0 of line card 1 on router 2. There are no features applied, so it's just MTU and the basic VRF config with IPv4 and IPv6 interfaces. So on all the interfaces, there are no QoS or ACL. So this is how the traffic generator is set up. Right now, we can start with 129 bytes, that is like one less than NDR. So what I'll be demonstrating now is bidirectional traffic. So if we look at the rate, it is set to 100% right now. I'll start the traffic at 129 frame length and show you that there is a slight drop. And then we'll increase it to NDR, that is 130. And again, go over the drop percentage to make sure there is zero drop. So this is bidirectional traffic. So right now I've started in both the directions. So if I just focus on the bottom right here to show the drop percentage, dropped frame percent right here, it's about 0.4% in one direction and 0.4 in the other direction. So what I will do now is just stop the traffic, change it to 130, and then we'll monitor all the show commands on the router as well. And I've just cleared the statistics and started the traffic. So here on the left side, we see the PX and RX L1 rate percentage. That's 99.996 from the traffic generator. And right now the drop percentage is a zero for both the streams. So I'll just go over the monitor interface star to actually show that the traffic is indeed flowing through all the ports of the system. Dial counters G location 00. So this I would think of it as a better view. So this tells us exactly how much traffic is on the ingress. So if you look at arrow marks here, so this is into the Jericho. This is the traffic that is flowing into the NPU. And from the NPU, if we scroll all the way to the bottom, this is the traffic that goes into the fabric. And then there is a command that we can look at the fabric statistics also. So show controller fabric plane all statistics. This actually tells us the in-cells and out-cells through each of the fabric cards. So this is the traffic that is on the fabric. And from the fabric, the reverse direction right here, this is the traffic that is again sent from the fabric towards the NPU. And also there was another test that was performed to actually run mini longevity kind of test with overnight snake traffic at 130 byte. So I've highlighted that this traffic profile was run for about more than 9 hours and there are zero drops. Along with that, there is power utilization capture too with both input and output, and same thing with respect to the CPU utilization. And there's no spike that is observed on the either the RPs or all the 8-line cards. We can do IMIX and say default IMIX. Let me show that to you. So this is the IMIX. So I can first change it to IMIX, and while we start the traffic, we can do the other testing. So this is the same line rate traffic with the IMIX profile. So before I change the config to add features, I'll just switch it to IPv6. So that way there won't be any change in the config. So let me just start the IPv6 traffic. So right now the traffic that is flowing is IPv6 at line rate with 130 byte size. I can just show you interface accounting to show that it is IPv6 unicast. And I can change it to show that there are drops at 129. Now, I'll leave the traffic flowing for either one of these IPv4 or IPv6 at 130 byte size, and then load the configuration with features, and we can see that there is no impact to the traffic. So I have two versions of config saved on the box with features. So I'll just load that on the first router first. So there is traffic flowing on the traffic generator, and this will load, replace the current config with the config with ACL and QoS on all the ports. So basically, when I run the snake test, the TTL value that is set, the maximum that we can set on the traffic is 255. Right. So because I'll have to actually do more than 255 hops, I had used a profile command to change the TTL. So basically this lets us match on a TTL value and set the TTL value on the router. So I've used that so that even before the TTL reaches 255, I basically increment it so that I achieve the entire 288 port snake. So the configuration profile that is loaded right now is ACL and QoS on all the ports. This config is applied on both the routers, and the traffic that is flowing right now is IPv4 at 130. So as you can see here, it's the same as what we have seen earlier, no drops at 130 frame length. So the QoS, the ingress QoS right here is, I'll just show sample class map as well, is to match a DSCP value and set the traffic classes. So I have 4 classes, and the 5th one is class default. So this is on the ingress, and on the egress side of it, these classes basically match the traffic class which is set on the ingress. 2 of them are with priority and the remaining are with bandwidth remaining. So this is the QoS configuration. Let me show you the statistics also. So everything right now is hitting the default class. And with respect to ACL, so there are about 4,000 ACEs for IPv4 and for IPv6 as well. So these are the large ACLs that are applied on all the ports. So now I'll switch to IPv6 for the same profile. So this is at 130 where there is no drop. We covered IPv4 VRF snake with and without features, and IPv6 snake with and without features. The other test I had here is with respect to the bundles. This is the slide to show how bundles are set up. So if you look at the ports that are highlighted in yellow, so those are 64 members, part of bundle ether 1. The ones highlighted in orange, that's another set of 64. Those are all part of bundle ether 2 and so on. So that way, yellow, orange, blue, and the peach color. So four bundles of 64 members each. And the remaining 31 codes are part of the fifth logical bundle, bundle ether 5. So this is how the bundles are laid out. So this is what I just spoke about, the five bundles. So now the traffic that I'll be starting is first IPv4. So these are all BGP prefixes, and the total number of flows that I'm sending are about 100K flows. The distribution is per source IP and destination IP addresses. The hashing can also be obtained based on the source port and destination port, but this test that I've set up is based on the source destination prefixes. In order to see how the traffic is getting load balanced, we'll go over two things. One is the ECMP to see the traffic split on all the five bundles, and then we'll look at per member. So these are the five bundles, and we see the in and out, it's almost 16.89 on all the five bundles. And same thing, I'll just monitor interface of all the members of line card 1, because they're all part of bundle ether 1. So this will display the lag, how the traffic is hashed across the bundle members from the same bundle. So I'll just quickly switch to IPv6. The drop again is 0. Let me expand this just. So the variation here is based on the source IP address and the destination IP address, and I have a total of 25,000 flows. So V6 prefix is also reachable via 5 bundles, and I started the IPv6 traffic, and this is the ECMP across 5 bundles. So these are all the members from bundle ether 1. So the drop right here is a real-time, it's a variation what Spiron use, but once I stop the traffic, ideally it should all go back to zero. So this is what we can look at, zero drop count.
Thanks, Pratyusha. Also, thanks to you for watching the video. Don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel and use the comment section if you have any question. See you soon.